Now, I like to call Scarlxrd the beast of hip-hop because this might be the only word I could describe this man with. If for some reason you're still not familiar with his music, then you definitely will be after this video. Now, that song right there is called Heart Attack, and that's the track that made Scarlxrd absolutely blow up on the internet about a year ago. The music video has over 28 million views on YouTube and over 10 million streams on Spotify, which is of course a lot for an artist that still hasn't gotten any mainstream attention at all, especially when the artist we're talking about here has what you would call an acquired taste, which means that the first time you actually hear his music, there's a big chance that you might not like it, but over time, as you keep going back to it and keep experiencing it, then you might actually start to like it, which is exactly what happened to me when I first heard his Heart Attack track only a couple days after it dropped. I remember listening to it and instantly getting turned off because it simply was so far from anything I've ever listened to before, but of course I did become a fan since I'm now making this video on him. Someone who kinda comes close to the lane Scarlxrd is in is none other than XXXTentacion. But then again, even though a lot of people do compare them and say that they do sound very much alike, I honestly think that Scarlxrd is very much in his own world and absolutely killing the lane he's in without sounding too much like anybody. As I'm listening to Scarlxrd's music, I'm realizing that him and Post Malone actually have one thing in common that could be seen as an advantage. And you're probably thinking, what exactly is there that Scarlxrd and Post Malone possibly can have in common? And it's the fact that they're both very hard to define. I've always felt like Post Malone has been a little bit hard to put a label on when it comes to exactly what kind of music he makes, because one minute it sounds like R&B and rap, and the other minute it sounds like country mixed with a little bit of rap and then mixed with R&B. And Scar is definitely in that space where he's inspired by things like metal. His raps are extremely experimental, the way he constantly shifts his intensity from 10% to 70% within 1 second, as he's holding that very sharp and energetic flow, really just makes Scarlxrd hard to recognize in terms of where he directly fits into the current wave of hip-hop. If I could describe Scarlxrd's music with three words, then it would be dark, intense, and experimental. I really don't think there's too many artists who are willing to go to the extent of what Scar is doing, because in the grand scheme of things, there's so many people who are not gonna like it, for the simple fact that it sounds so different, and when people do get exposed to it one time, they might not even give it a chance because it's not the usual, so to speak. And that's kind of a blessing and a curse when it comes to art in general. On one hand, you want your music to appeal to everybody, but at the same time, there's a risk you have to take, because if you try to reach everybody, you'll end up reaching nobody. But I personally think that he's doing a good job at owning his own lane. There's a different kind of confidence that's just bleeding out of him whenever he's rapping on his tracks, and even though you might not be a fan of him and feel like what he's doing is not interesting to you, I think it's hard to not appreciate the level of rawness you hear in his music. And I've noticed that there's two different sides to Scarlxrd when it comes to his music. There's the more hip-hop oriented version of him, and then there's the more metal oriented version of him. One example of his metal oriented side is his track Lies You Tell. And one example of his more hip-hop oriented side is his track 4 AM or 4/AM. That aggressive style that he always keeps just goes so well with his voice. And it's funny because I always hear a lot of people say, well, screaming on your songs is easy, isn't it? I mean, the only thing he's doing is just screaming, right? And to that I say, try that for 1 minute and then come back to this video and let's see who ends up in hospital with a broken vocal cord. So no, it's really not an easy thing. I mean, the style Scarlxrd has is kind of like singing. If you really think about it, everybody can sing, but at the same time, everybody can't do it well. And the same thing goes for screaming. I don't really think there's a difference here. Now, one thing I've always been interested in when it comes to quote-unquote screaming rappers, or just aggressive and extreme music in general, is how does it really affect us? And I was just thinking to myself, there's gotta be some type of psychological effect when it comes to listening to someone like Scarlxrd, because his music is indeed very intense. Because there's a big difference between listening to some calm R&B versus Scarlxrd. Anyway, so I actually did a little bit of, you know, research on the internet, and I found an interesting study. Basically, what the study showed is that listening to extreme music makes you calmer, not angrier. Now, what they did was take 39 extreme music listeners between the ages of 18 and 34. They put them in a room for 10 minutes where they were doing a random assignment while listening to extreme, or what some would call violent, music from their own playlist. And the other 10 minutes, they did the same assignment, but this time they did it in silence. And it's also important to add in that before they did 10 minutes of silence and the 10 minutes of extreme music, they did a 16 minutes of what they would call an anger induction. Basically, the point of this anger induction was to see if the 10 minutes of silence or the 10 minutes of extreme music would calm the listeners down. Because the thing about the anger induction part is that it involves each participant describing topics that might inspire irritation, such as relationships, money, or work. So the purpose was to actually get the participants emotional before they did 10 minutes of silence and 10 minutes of extreme music. Because at the end, they want to find out that if the music could calm them down. Hopefully that wasn't too confusing. I tried to explain it as best as I could. Anyway, let's keep going. So at the end of the study, the conclusion they came to was this. This study found that extreme music fans listen to music when angry to match their anger and to feel more active and inspired. They also listen to music to regulate sadness and enhance positive emotions. The results refute the notion that extreme music causes anger, but further research is required to replicate these findings in naturalistic social contexts. Now, this study was actually aimed towards metal music, and the good thing about that is Scarlxrd's music is very much metal inspired, which makes the study relevant to him. As you can see, although they did say that more research was required to find out how accurate the results really are in different situations, the study still stands, and it definitely destroys the assumption that just because you listen to someone like Scarlxrd who has quote-unquote extreme music, that would make you a more violent person. I mean, doesn't it make sense? Yes, it does actually make sense, but that's only if you look at it from a surface level, because clearly it calms people down because they use this kind of music as an outlet for their emotions to get expressed through him, which is Scarlxrd. I watched an interview he did with Noisy a couple days ago where he was talking about UK rap, because he is from the UK, if you didn't know. He was talking about how he doesn't really fit in with that kind of space just because of how different his music sounds and how different he actually looks in terms of style. And that just goes to show that even though he comes from a place like the UK where the grime scene is the hot thing, out of all that came this guy called Scarlxrd, who's a metal-inspired, emo, dark, intense, experimental rapper whose music you could go to whenever you want to express your intense, dark moments through yourself. And yeah, that's why Scarlxrd is a beast, and that's why you need to listen to him if you don't already.